It's time for another episode of the Faith Fight podcast. Today we're going to talk about considering the ants. Hello again, everybody. Thank you for tuning into this episode of the Faith Fight podcast. I'm your host, Chris Creary, and I'm so grateful that you took time out of your day to listen. I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. Thank you for tuning in today, and I hope all is well with you. For those of you tuning in for the first time, I want to let you know that you can find the Faith Fight podcast on all of the major podcasting apps, on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible. And I've recently uploaded all the podcasts to YouTube. So if you use any of those apps to listen to podcasts, you can just search the Faith Fight podcast and you'll be able to subscribe to this podcast and receive every future episode that I release on a Monday morning. And I'm praying that it will be a blessing to you. And I also have an archive of over 200 episodes. So if there's anything that you are going through right now, and if you need to find encouraging Bible verses, or if you need someone to stand in agreement with you, I pray at the end of every single episode, just scroll through the different topic titles that I have in the archives and download and listen to any one of those past episodes. So if you're praying for your children, I have covered an episode on how to pray for your kids. If you're looking for a new job, or if you run a business and you want to hear what the Bible says about that, I've covered episodes on that in the past. I've spoken about faith and how to increase your level of faith, and I've covered episodes on that. Or if you just need to learn how to pray, I recently did 2 weeks of episodes on the Faith Fight podcast about prayer and how we can use the Our Father as a template and plug in the Word of God into the Our Father prayer and use that to supercharge and power your prayers through the power of the Holy Spirit and the Word of God. So I've covered all of those things in the past, and you can get to all of my past episodes, even going back to the very first episode of the Faith Fight podcast, just by clicking the link in the description to get to the archives. Or you can scroll back in any one of those podcasts and apps that I mentioned, and you can scroll back and listen, look at any one of the episodes and download them and listen to them and allow them to be a blessing to you. So I've placed a link in the description to get to the archives, and also a link to all of those podcast directories that I mentioned. They're all in the description and you can follow them, or you can just go to those directories themselves and just search the Faith Fight podcast. You will find this podcast once you search that way. And for everyone else coming back again, thank you for tuning in once again. I'm praying a special prayer for you that God will give you the boldness and the confidence to share this podcast with someone else. Because if you were blessed by something you heard on the Faith Fight podcast, chances are there is someone that you know who would be blessed as well. And it's a blessing to God's kingdom when we all can grow and mature through what we hear and what we experience and what we learn about God's kingdom. So share this episode of the podcast with someone else so that they can listen, learn, and be blessed and give God glory as they mature and grow into the things that God has called them to do. So share this with someone else so it can be a blessing to them. Now, I got some really exciting news that I want to share with you guys. It's two things. The first thing is I've just launched my first Christian t-shirt apparel store. Go on to this link that I'm going to share in the description, and you can buy a t-shirt to support the Faith Fight podcast and boldly declare your faith wherever you go. If you are blessed in the city and blessed in the field, I have a t-shirt for you. If you are forgetting the things that are behind you, and if you are pressing forward, I have a t-shirt for you. I've placed links in the description so that you can get to my store and you can buy a t-shirt. So support the podcast by buying a t-shirt for yourself, for a loved one as a gift, for someone who's graduating, for someone who just got baptized. Maybe you can give them a t-shirt and bless them and encourage them. And I pray that it's a blessing to you. And I thank you for supporting the podcast. Now, the second piece of information that I want to share, which is really exciting, is that I'm working now with individuals or ministries who wish to start their own podcasts. So if you have call on your life to teach or to speak, or if you have a ministry where you teach every Sunday and you want to start a podcast, I will help you to do that. So I've placed a link in the description of this episode where you can get onto a form and fill out some information so that I can work with you so that we can launch your podcast of your ministry so that you can be a blessing to other people all over the world, just like how the Faith Fight podcast is a blessing to people all over the world. So if you're a pastor, a teacher, and you teach every single week, and if you want to turn those messages into podcast episodes, click the link in the description and we can work together and start a podcast for your ministry and continue to spread the good news of the gospel to all the ends of the earth. Now, today we're going to talk about considering the ants. So laziness is a big problem for some people. They want everything, but they are not motivated enough to get up and make something happen. And we can learn a lot from the ants in this regard. We should live a purpose-driven life and not waste time when we should be working. God will give us the energy to be productive, and He will give us the time to rest when it is time to do so. There's a lot that we can learn when we consider the ants, so that's what we're going to do today. So this episode is mainly based out of Proverbs 6, verses 6 to 11. So I'll read that right now, right before we get started. It says this: "Go to the ant, you sluggard. Consider its ways and be wise. It has no commander, no overseer or ruler, yet it stores its provisions in summer and gathers its food at harvest. How long will you lie there, you sluggard? When will you get up from your sleep? A little sleep, a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to rest, and poverty will come upon you like a thief, and scarcity like an armed man." And again, that was Proverbs 6, verses 6 to 11. So the first lesson that we can learn when we consider the ants is that ants are self-motivated to make it happen. And I get this from a verse in Proverbs 6, where it says, "It has no commander, no overseer or ruler." Now, the only people that you should tell what to do are kids, and that is because they don't know any better. Adults should know what they are responsible for doing every single day. Just like when we see the ant, they don't have a ruler, but they go out every day to collect food because they know their survival during the winter depends on it. So if you are like this, and if you need someone to tell you what to do all the time, we need to show the initiative. We don't need a ruler or an overseer or someone to direct us to do everything that we need to do. We need to be responsible for our own actions and make it happen for ourselves. If there is something that God put on your heart to do, get up and muster the strength in the power of the Holy Spirit to go out and make it happen. Don't wait for someone to push you or to motivate you or to encourage you to do it. You get up and encourage yourself to make it happen. The next lesson that we can learn when we consider the ants is that they have great foresight. And going back to Proverbs chapter 6, it says, "Yet it stores its provision in summer and gathers its food at harvest." Now, during the summer months, we may see this from time to time as we relax and enjoy the weather. But during this season, the ant is hard at work collecting food to store up for the winter. So we don't know when our seasons of life will change, but we need to recognize when we are in a season of plentiful and when hard work is required to collect and store your harvest. There may be a season that will come when you won't be able to work and the opportunities will be gone. So pray for discernment and recognize these seasons and when they change so that you can make the correct decisions in your life. The next thing that we can learn when we consider the ants is that they are purpose-driven. And I'm going to read Hebrews 10, verse 38 to 39. It says this: "And but my righteous one will live by faith, and I take no pleasure in the one who shrinks back. But we do not belong to those who shrink back and are destroyed, but to those who have faith and are saved." Now, if you ever seen an ant trying to get to some food or something that is on the ground, you will see that it is very determined. If you put a rock or an obstacle between an ant and that food, the ant will crawl around, over, or underneath even if it can to get to what it set its mind on getting. Likewise, we need to have the same type of determination to accomplish whatever God has placed in front of us to accomplish. There may be an obstacle that is trying to block us, but it's not time for us to shrink back, but we need to pray and seek God for strength to overcome it. Because if God gave us the vision and the power to do something, He would also strengthen us to overcome any challenges that may try to stop us from doing that. Now, the next thing we need to think about when we consider the ants is that they work together. And I'm going to read Hebrews 10, verse 24 to 25. It says, "And let us consider how we may spur on one another towards love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching." Now, when you consider ants, if there is ever a crumb of food that is too big for one ant to carry, you will often see two or more ants working together to carry that crumb back to their home for everyone to enjoy. Or they will go back to the anthill and tell everyone where the food is, and they will gather around that food or that crumb that is on the ground and enjoy it together. I recently seen this on one day when I went out for a jog and I saw a dark spot on the sidewalk. I didn't know what it was, but when I got closer to it, it was thousands or even a million ants, and they were surrounding a piece of food that was on the ground, and they were all enjoying it. Maybe one ant found it and told the rest where they can come and enjoy the food. Now, we need to be like these ants as well and encourage and help other believers do great things for the glory of God's kingdom. And when we encourage and help each other, we all grow, we all benefit, and we all bless the kingdom of God, just as the ants all got to enjoy that food that was on the ground. So we need to remember to encourage and help each other and work together as we go about our day-to-day Christian lives. And the final point that I'm going to mention today when we consider the ants is that ants are stronger than you think. And I'm going to read 2 Corinthians 12, verse 9. It says, "But he said to me, 'My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me.'" So from our perspective, ants are tiny insects, and we often just step on them to kill them if they ever get in our house or if they're, you know, messing them with our picnic or anything like that. But if we look at how strong an ant is compared to its size, we would be amazed. An ant can carry 10 to 50 times their own body weight. And just to put that in perspective, it's as if a grown man that weighs 180 pounds is able to lift and carry a full-grown cow. So as believers, we need to remember that God knows the strength that He has placed inside of us. When challenges and obstacles come in our way, we all need to learn how to rest on the strength of God to overcome those challenges. I'm not saying that we need to go and lift a cow, which is physically impossible for us, but what I am saying is that if there are challenges that you don't feel like you can overcome, pray and ask God for spiritual strength to overcome and be successful. And we exercise our strength through prayer. As we pray, God will move the situation or the obstacle through His divine power and His strength. Because as this verse in 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9 says, that in our weakness, Christ's power will rest upon us. And God's grace is sufficient. So let's pray right now. And if you're doing anything that requires your direct attention, please keep your eyes open and I'm going to pray and you can agree with me through saying amen. So Father, we just want to thank you as we come before your presence right now. We give you the glory, the praise, and the honor, Lord God, as we approach you, Heavenly Father. I thank you for your amazing love, your compassion, O God, and O God, that you've woken us up to see another day. We are so grateful that we have our Heavenly Father that looks down upon us and cares for every single thing that concerns us. As we approach your throne of grace right now, Lord God, we ask you to have mercy upon us, cleanse us, and forgive us, O God. I thank you, Lord God, for the fresh cleansing of the blood of Jesus that causes us to be in right standing with you, and for all that he has done, O God, in our lives to cause us, to allow us to be in communication and relationship with you. And as we come before you now, Lord God, I pray for every single person listening, Lord God, that we will consider the ants, O God, and think about things that they do, O God, and see how we can apply them into our lives, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you have given us purpose, O God, and put a plan in our lives, and every single one of our days have been written down even before one of them came to pass. And this is what your word says, Lord. So Father, I pray that your Holy Spirit will motivate us and encourage us to continue to pursue the things that you have placed for us to do, Lord God. Help us to be self-motivated, O God, internally motivated to accomplish all that you have placed before us, all that you have impressed upon our hearts to do, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, that your Holy Spirit will give us the strength to do it, Lord God, that we will not wait for another person to encourage us or to help us, O God, but we will be internally motivated, O God, spurred on by the unction of your Holy Spirit, Lord God, to do what you've called us to do, Lord God. And we thank you for your Holy Spirit, Lord God, because your Holy Spirit gives us insight and foresight on what we should do in the future, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, and I pray that, O God, that we will know the times and the seasons, Lord God, and know what to do, just like the sons of Issachar, Lord God, that they knew exactly what to do in the seasons, Lord God. And Lord, that when we operate, O God, according to your divine seasons that you have for us, O God, that we will prosper, Lord God, and that we will accomplish the things that you have for us to do, Lord. So I pray, O God, that you will give us the insight and the discernment, O God, to know what to do in every season, Lord God. And as we continue to seek you, Lord God, help us to remember our purpose, Lord God. Father, as we conform not to this world, O God, but be transformed by the renewing of our mind, Lord God, and then we will know what is your will for us, O God, your good, perfect, and pleasing will for us, Lord God. And we thank you, Lord God, that we will not shrink back, Lord God, when we know that will that you have for us, but we will continue to press forward, O God, and continue to do what you've called us to do, Lord God, and not let any obstacles, O God, stop us from accomplishing what you've placed before us, Lord God. So we thank you, Lord God, and may, O God, you send your angels around us to strengthen us as we continue to seek you, O God, that we may encourage each other every single day, Lord God, that we may lift up each other, Lord God, and speak loving, kind words, Lord God, that will encourage other believers to continue to pursue, O God, the things that you've placed for us to do. And we thank you, Lord God, for the power of your Holy Spirit living inside of us, Lord God, because as your word says, Lord God, your grace is sufficient, Lord God. So Lord God, may our weaknesses, O God, may we boast in our weaknesses, O God, that your strength, O God, will be exalted through us, Lord God. So I thank you, Father God, that in my weakness, O God, that you are glorified, Lord God. In my, O God, limitations, O God, you are exalted. So Father God, I pray this for every single person listening right now, Lord God, that as we decrease, that you will be exalted and increase in us and through us, Lord God. So we thank you for hearing our prayer today, Lord God. We bless you, we honor you, Lord God, and we commit all that we are and have into your hands. And I plead the blood of Jesus Christ upon myself and every single person listening. May your perfect will be done in our lives, Lord God, and may your angels minister and strengthen us and direct us and lead us in every step that we take today. I thank you, Heavenly Father, and I place all that we are and have and every single person listening into your hands, Lord God. And I know that you are faithful to keep that which I commit unto you, Lord God. So we give you the praise right now, Lord God. We thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. So that's it for another episode of the Faithified Podcast, and I hope that you were blessed by this episode. And if you were blessed, you can go over to Apple Podcasts and you can subscribe to the Faithified Podcast there. You can put a 5-star review and you can write your testimony in the little comment section there so that other people can see it and be blessed by what you have to say. And if you don't use an Apple phone to listen to podcasts, you can listen to the podcast through Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible, and also on YouTube. So go onto those apps and search the Faithified Podcast, and you can subscribe to the podcast and leave comments of how this podcast blessed you on any one of those apps. And remember to also follow the links in the description to support the Faithified Podcast by buying a Christian t-shirt that I've designed and created myself. The links are there in the description and they will be a blessing to you. You can give it away to someone as a gift. You can give it away to someone as an encouragement for them to remember that they are blessed in the city and blessed in the field. And I thank you for supporting the Faithified Podcast. And also, if you have a ministry and if you want to create a podcast just like this so that you can share your message with other people across the world, connect with me so that I can help you do that. There's a link in the description that you can reach out to me and then we can work together and we can take it from there and bring the good news of the gospel to all the ends of the earth, as it says in the Great Commission. So partner with me as we do that together. And finally, remember to share this episode with someone else so that they can be blessed as well. And remember to put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Something good is going to happen to you today. Be blessed.